Before the American Revolution, the English entered houses and buildings to seize prohibited goods from the colonists. The colonists were not happy with this activity, and consequently our founding fathers created an amendment within the Bill of Rights prohibiting illegal search and seizures. The Fourth Amendment requires a warrant supported with probable cause in order for search and seizure to occur. Wiretapping has occurred since the 1890s and was made a felony in the state of New York in 1892. Wiretapping was a popular tool for catching bootleggers during the Prohibition era, and several court cases debated the legality of wiretapping. In 1934, Congress passed the Federal Communications Act, which made it illegal to intercept and reveal wire communications. As World War II broke out in Europe, controversial FBI Director J. Edgar Hoover convinced President Roosevelt to let the FBI resume wiretapping in cases involving national security. It is now known that J. Edgar Hoover used the information that he gathered to discredit politicians who were trying to limit the power of the FBI, and this continued throughout his 48-year history as the director of the FBI. In 1952, the National Security Agency was formed and could now use computers to search for words and phrases that detected criminal activity. The power of the NSA strengthened as a result of the Cold War and began to listen in on the conversations of suspected communists and American groups opposed to the war. The Electronic Communications Privacy Act was passed in 1986 and allowed police to conduct roving wiretaps that moved from phone to phone in order to show if a suspect was attempting to avoid the surveillance. The Stored Communications Act, which is part of the Electronic Communications Privacy Act, allows the government to search and obtain information from an internet service provider's email messages more than 180 days old without a warrant. The act justifies this by explaining that a user is giving up privacy after the internet provider has stored the information. Due to advancements in technology, Congress passed the Communications Assistance for Law Enforcement Act in 1994. The law required networking equipment used by phone companies to be designed so that law enforcement agencies could trace calls and emails and listen in on telephone calls. The attacks on September 11th ushered in a new age of warrantless wiretapping. The National Security Agency wanted to listen to telephone conversations that they believed would help to avoid another terrorist attack. Shortly after, Congress passed the United States Patriot Act, which gave officials greater authority to monitor communication and define new crimes and penalties for terrorist activity. The Patriot Act, signed by President Bush, does not require probable cause to be demonstrated for a search, and it also allows law enforcement to circumstantially search homes without a warrant. Many critics of the Patriot Act believe that this act violates the Fourth Amendment as well as the civil liberties and privacy of the American people. In 2010, a judge ruled that warrantless wiretapping was illegal, and the decision is still under appeal by the Obama administration.
Watching me.